touch back on your heels. Oh, you met someone and now you know how it feels. When you give your heart so true, like I gave mine to you, and you break it in little pieces. What I have to do, you done gone my way, keep gonna sing those blues all night. Baby, those loved ones fell to dynamite. Oh, hooray, hallelujah, whoa, you had it coming to you. Goody, goody for you. Goody, goody for you. I hope you're satisfied, you rascal.
Everything's gonna be alright. Now, did you ever have to pay for something that you didn't do? Did you ever figure out the reason why? When the doctor says this is gonna hurt me a lot more than this hurts you, did you ever figure out that that's a lie? He knows it ain't hard. get along with somebody else's troubles, and they don't make Bleus any sweet at night. As long as baby's out there busting somebody else's bubbles, everything's gonna be alright. Everything is gonna be alright. They don't make him lose any sleep at night. Just as long as Spade's out there busting somebody else's bubbles, everything's gonna be alright. And I asked the old undertaker what it took to make him laugh when all he ever saw is people crying. First he hands me a bunch of flowers that he received on my behalf, and he says the business just gets better all the time. Said it ain't too hard to get along with somebody else's troubles, and they don't make him lose any sleep at night. Just as long as Spade's out there busting somebody else's bubbles, everything's gonna be alright. Everything is gonna be alright. I'd like to drink some Royal Crown Cola for you now. You're kidding. Some incredible rule about buying alcoholic spirits with state funds or something like that. Great. You, baby, you fed me on chicken and wine. It was steak and potatoes, but I sure felt fine. But now all you give me is seaweed, alfalfa sprouts, and sunflower seeds, and I got my doubts. Baby, you left me here with the chicken cordon bleu. Oh, my stomach is empty and all I got is food. All I got is food for thought. I've been sitting here thinking about the 20 pounds of groceries we bought. We bought 10 pounds of brown rice and 5 more roast beans. 5 pounds of grain. granola, and you know what that means. I'm a regular fella. I got that chicken cart on the is so strange, those old cockroaches move next door. Baby, can you see that old dog who's standing out in the street? He got a big smile on his face, 'cause they let him eat meat, and I got you, and I got the chicken cordon. Song called One Down and One to Go. I didn't get it quite finished yet. The subtitle is Just the Way Things Always Are in Baltimore. Never quite got it finished yet. I don't think they should have let Nixon pick. And vice versa, I screwed up everything else he picked. Let somebody else take a shot at picking something. I don't know, all politicians are a little bit crazy. The only one of them who had a piece of paper that said he was sane was Thomas Eagleton. There was in black and white. He took the cure. And even he blew it. I saw him stand on TV and hold the paper up and shake it and go, I'm not crazy. This song is just to show you that avarice is a bipartisan proposition, and it's not limited to federal situation. This is a song about a fellow who died a couple years ago named Paul Powell. He was the Secretary of State under a couple of governors, one of them being Otto Kerner, who later became a federal judge. Later indicted and made a federal prisoner. They found all that money in those shoe boxes, but they never found 128 pairs of Tom McCann Romans. Song's called Your $750,000 Shoes They Hurt My Feet, Lord. Or when it's coupon clipping time at Arlington, Mama, I'll come shoebox and back to you. how Powell went down Springfield. When he was a boy, he was sworn to serve the people of the state of Illinois. And he swore to serve them young, and he swore to serve them old, and he swore to serve them bullshit. He kept all the gold. It was years there he enchanted us, and we gave him the votes. And the ones we didn't give him, he bought with $100 notes. Then he said all kinds of stuff we liked to hear, and did a two-time dance. Had us locked up in the back pocket of his greasy, grimy pants. You're a thief and a bum, and where's all the money, and how come you lied to all those people, Mr. Powell? Betrayed the public trust, and now you're turning into dust, and you won't come around to bug us anymore. Paul Powell was his secretary, and that gave him control of all the stuff you need permits for. These he always sold to raise the funds for his campaign. And other sundry needs of the mound, the shoeboxes full of poor folks' cash in the closet with his tweeds. And they said you can't take it with you. I know a man who tried, but his secretary fumbled on the night the old dude died. And all the newspapers and radios shocked us with the news. The racetrack fall and picked our pockets. And whatever else was loose, you're a thief and a bum. Where's the money now? Come, you lied all those people, Mr. Powell. You betrayed the public trust. Now you're turning into dust, and you won't come around to rob us anymore. Paul Powell was laid to rest in a casket lined with gold, but his ghost lives on in other thieves, or so I've been told. There's crooks in every walk of life, and that I know is true. But the biggest bums are some of the ones we give our power to. In the history of Illinois, there was a lot of mighty men. I remember all Geld and old Abe Lincoln, and Dillinger and Capone. And I know to slur a dead man is a terrible disgrace. That's why I wish he was alive. We could tell him to his face, yeah. Where's the money? I come find all those people, Mr. Powell. Did you betray the public trust? I sort of hope your coffin rusts. Here's the Peter Paul and Mary ending. I took out a goddamn book. Well, you won't come around to rob us. No, you won't come around to rob us. No, you won't come around to rob us anymore.
Still hit the high notes. I've had this cold all week, and I flew in from Boston this morning. And there was a young man from Boston. I drove around in an Austin. I don't remember how it ended up. He couldn't get every. He tried to make love in an Austin, right? Everything. But his balls hung out and he lost them. Sort of lowers the curtain on respectability. It's all trash from here, mother.
Oh, okay.
on the practice. Good time I had by accident in England. The record company that... Oh, Jesse. Please don't. You got brandy in your milk. That's a great kid. She knows she's got me wrapped up. Nothing I can do about it. She just knows how far she can. Wow. They're great. I recommend them, you know. If you ever get into a situation where you think that might be a good thing to do, don't wait just because you're broke or something like that. Enough of that shit. This song here is a sort of an ode to younger tartan ale. I had the lip sync on the radio once in England. It happened. I didn't have a permit to do the show. It was called the BBC's Country Meets Folk Hour. So a cross between the Midnight Special and the Grand Ole Opry. I explained that sort of half records, half live action. It was all performed before 200 people sitting in a theater in central London. And very few people in London ever listened to it, but it was heard roundly in the countryside. But it supposedly had about 4 million listeners. And I had to lip sync because I didn't have a permit to do it, so I had to stand there with the guitar and sing from the mouth of words for the 200 people in the studio audience while they played the record out or the radio. And I was doing anything but playing the song, and so the 200, it was a serious song, I can't remember which one it was, but I think it was Would You Like Learning to Dance or something like that. And the audience was laughing hysterically through the whole thing. So, and the announcer said, thank you very much. And now we have Red Sullivan. And I went to walk off, and as Red came on, he said, now, it's a shame you didn't have a permit to sing, right? He said, because you should get to sing as long as you're here. So come out and sing on my song. And he turned me around. And I didn't know the song he was going to sing. And I figured that there was no one within 4,000 miles to get to him about that. So I just went back out there. I figured that if you're going to make a fool of yourself, that's as good a place to be. And he began to sing, I can't get my winkle out, isn't that a sin? The more I try to get it out, the further it goes in. I can't get my winkle out, isn't that a doer? I can't get it out with an old bent pin, does anybody have a skewer? A winkle is a kind of shellfish they have there. I didn't know that. And so this song's for that situation, I guess, but it's also for Younger's Tartan Beer, which will set you free. You can't get it here, you know, it's not like Watney's or anything like that. They don't, just don't export it. You can only get it in Scotland or England. And the 6 hours referred to in the title, I'm going to sing it. One of these days I'm going to sing the song. The 6 hours, there's the time difference between London's airport and O'Hare. It's a 9-hour plane flight that left London at 12:30 and landed in Chicago at 3:30. One more night in a transatlantic city. Clocks all run on someone else's time. And the streets run so close to the highways, but none of them run into mine. And the people are all in a hurry, and the whiskey's just as cheap as the beer. That skyline
darling, I wish you again. Some folks travel for pleasure. Some folks are just born to roam. Some folks can't stand the pressure. Some folks never come home. I only go where I have to go. And I only come home when I'm done. And if everything's right, then I'll be home Friday night. 6 hours ahead of the sun. Transatlantic. Buy one round for everyone inside. And you order up the same old glass of trouble. The trouble just don't taste the same tonight. The local bartender tells the same story. And the local lovelies dance before your eyes. And they call that dance old Younger's Tarnin'. And I can't get all this mud out of my eyes. Some folks drink when they're happy. Some folks drink when they're dry. Some folks drink so they won't have to think. Some folks drink until they die. Drinking just gives me amnesia. And the devil has a list of those who run. Run, win, place, and show, and no place to go. And 6 hours ahead of the sun. Run, win, place, and show, and nowhere to go. And 6 hours ahead of the sun.
From deep inside, like my heart's going to break. Every moment is sharp and painful, and I may never shake. First pain is involved in the name of the one I'll never replace. Somebody new came up to win her, and I can ride in second place. The race is on, and here comes time for the backstretch. Heart ain't going to place. I'm not calm. Out of the funnies, the scrap for another save. The race is on and it looks like heartache. The winner loses all.
Ow. I'm not gonna do that now.
There's a couple of songs that I really like that almost need this. This one I just heard on the radio about a week ago. I heard Bobby Bear sing this. This has got its merits. I think this is one of Shell Soldier's.
I'm all choked up, but let me thank you for the party once again. It was such a kind and thoughtful thing to do. I look around and I see the smiling faces of old friends, and everybody's here, but you know who. We're gathered here tonight to celebrate the happy union of plenty of beer and lots of wine. There's plenty everything but love, 'cause everybody's here except you know. On my hard luck days, I really do have to laugh. I was working in a dive for $26 and I spent it all on grass. And we were hungry, hard luck heroes trying to stay alive. So we go down to the Cordon grocery, survive. Now who's gonna steal the peanut butter? Now get the can of sardines. Running up and down the aisle of the mini marts, looking food in our jeans. And we never took more than we could eat. There's plenty left on the rack. We always swore if we ever got rich, we would pay the mini mart back. Yes, sir, yes, sir, we would pay the mini mart back. It was a two-man operation. We had it all down to the nose. Old Eddie would watch that big round mirror, and I'd fill up my coat. And then we'd head for the checkout line with a lemon and a bottle of beer. Hurry on up, gotta get on home, 'cause supper time's almost here. Now who's going to steal the peanut butter? And I get the can of sardines. Running up and down the aisle of the mini mart, sticking food in our jeans. Oh, we never took more than we could eat. There's plenty left on the rack. We all swore if we ever got rich, we'd go and pay the mini mart back. Yes, sir, yes, sir, we'd pay the mini mart back. I guess everybody's had some hard times, and I know I've had my share. It seems sort of funny to laugh at that now, but I don't want to go back there. So every now and then when I'm in the grocery, I take a little but not much. 'Cause you never know when those hard times will get you. I don't want to lose my touch. Now we're gonna steal a peanut butter, and I get the can of sardines. Running up and down the aisle of the mini mart, sticking food. Oh, never took more than we could eat. There was plenty left on the rack. And we always swore if we ever got rich that we would pay the mini mart back. Yes, sir, yes, sir, we would pay the mini mart back. Yes, sir, yes, sir, we would pay the mini mart back.
Good to see you, comrade. Just one word. Some bitch fucking ain't good.
God damn. God damn.
Just once, I'd just like to see you. Gotta get the angle right. The last one like this. John Pine and I wrote this by accident one night. under duress. We were in New York City and we tried to write the Nashville song that had everything in it. The Nashville song that always had it in them all in one song. This is what came out. It's not easy to do that. They only let you use three chords. I don't have to go through it. It's the three that was in the other two songs. In different keys, but it's the same three. And every now and then you're allowed to use four. Get right into the union in advance. Lean into the mic at a 45 degree angle. The song's called You Never Even Call Me By My Name, or She Criticized My Apartment, So I Knocked Her Flat. Or Don't Wait Up for the Lobster Boats, Grandma. Grandpa's Coming Home with the Crabs. From crying.
Sometimes it seems so useless to remain. You're the one who always tried to change me. That is why I'll always stay the same. But I'll hang around as long as you will let me. I never minded standing in the rain. You don't have to call me darling, darling, but you never even call me by my name. No, you don't have to call me Porter Wagoner. You don't have to call me Charlie Cry. You don't have to call me Merle Haggard anymore, even though you know you're on my fighting side. And I'm gonna hang around as long as you let me. I never minded standing in the rain. No, you don't have to call me darling, darling, but you never even call me by my name. Here's the pedal steel break we wrote for this. Mention my name a few times in the phone book. And on the neon sign above the bar I used to own. And there's only one thing I'm gonna hear it when my Savior calls me home. We left out everything good. Trans. With all due respect, you can't have a good country song without mother, farms, prison, trains and trucks, and the song's already 4 minutes long, and I couldn't fit this. I just put this verse on it. Ever since the day my mama went to prison, what there's my family around this farm that's been the same. And you know that when they let her out last Tuesday, she drove her goddamn truck into a train. Well, I'm gonna
This song about a man named Ross Cassio on the lake of Tony. I didn't know he was this popular in DeKalb. That called me sort of think he's an asshole. And he's German Shepherd dogs. Still got them. They got new ones. By gents in the fenders of the car. They're towing it a lot. Fuller than now. Lamps are on in Chicago tonight, and lovers are gazing at stars. The stores are all closing, and Daly is dozing, and Casio's counting the cars. There are more cars than places to put up, he says, but I got room for them all. So round them up, boys, cause I want some more toys, and hit the lot by the grocery store. Anyway, hey, oh, I'm away, the Lincoln Park Pirates are we. From Wilmette to Gary, there's none that's so hairy, and we always collect our fee. Way, hey, it's home away, we plunder the streets of your town. Be it Edsel or Chevy, there's no car too heavy, and no one can make us shut down. Break into cars when we gotta, with pickaxe and hammer and saw. And they said this garage had no license, but little care I for the law. All my drivers are friendly and courteous, their good manners you always will get, cause they all are recent graduates of the charm school in Joliet. Come me away, hey, tow them away, and the Lincoln Park Pirates are we. From Wilmette to Gary, there's none that's so hairy, and we always collect our fee. To me away, hey, tow them away, and we plunder the streets of your town. Be it Edsel or Chevy, there's no car too heavy, and no one can make us shut down. And when all the cars are collected and all of their fenders are ruined, and I'll tow every boat in the Belmont Harbor to the Lincoln Park Lagoon. And when I've collected the ransom and I've sunk all the ones that won't yield, I'll tow the goddamn planes that are blocking the runways out at O'Hare Field. To me, way, hey, tow them away, the Lincoln Park Pirates away. From Wilmette to Gary, there's none that's so hairy, and we always collect our fee. Chimmy way, hey, tow them away, and citizens gather around. And I think it's enough, let's call his bluff, let's talk about out of town. haven't done this in a long time.
Let's see if I can remember this.
This was written by Greg Hildebrand. I'd almost forgotten. It's just nice to be home. I forgot what it was like to sing songs about Chicago and Illinois. I'm gonna get this straight here. Kitchen door, but the door then broke down. I walked into my living room, and what do you think I see? There's four great big old ugly studs sitting there waiting for me. I say, gangsters, burglars, who the hell are you? You look like a bunch of Skid Row bums or monkeys from the zoo. If it wasn't for the cut of those crummy clothes, which leaves me in some doubt, I think it was a bunch of them mafia thugs come in here to rub me out. They said, "Eat it, pervert, don't talk that way to me." I found your roommate with a stash of hash and some cubes of LRD. There's a bottle of Milltown on your dresser and you're as good as dead. If you want to keep your body in one piece, keep a civil tongue in your head. And I said, "Police, it's the police." By Christ, I should have seen. Those mafia fellas ain't near as dumb, nowhere half as mean. And that's when they threw me up against the wall. I said, "Please stop. It hit me one more time. I think I'd call a cop." I said, "Officer, I don't know what you're talking about. Besides, you're in such a rush. I never set foot in this house before. Would you like to buy a fuller brush?" So, hipsters and vipers, here's what you gotta do. It's election year in Chicago, and you better hide all the blue. 'Cause Tony Rigoni is a narco man, and he's got a nose for grass. Yes? Then he tied me up.
"Help, he's tying me up."
Turned on the buzzsaw.
"Help."
The train was coming.
"Help."
If Tony ever catches you turning on, it's surely gonna be your ass. There's one more with almost that same tune. This is a Homer and Jethro thing. God, I haven't done these in a while. This is almost my favorite song. "Many, many years ago when I was 23, I was married to a widow who was pretty as could be. This widow had a grown-up daughter who had hair of red. My father fell in love with her, and soon these two were wed. This made my dad my son-in-law, and it changed my life. My daughter was my mother because she was father's wife. To complicate the situation, though it brought me joy, I soon became a father to a bouncing baby boy. This little baby then became a brother-in-law to Dad. That made him my uncle, though it made me sad. 'Cause if he was my uncle, then he also was a brother to the widow's grown-up daughter, who, of course, was my stepmother. And father's wife had a great big son who kept him on the run. He became my grandchild 'cause he was my daughter's son. And my wife is now my mother's mother, and that makes me blue. Because although she is my wife, she's my grandmother too. And if my wife is my grandmother, then I'm her grandmother.
every time I think of that, it almost drives me wild. Now I have become the strangest case you ever saw. As husband to my grandmother, I am my own grandpa. Well, I'm my own grandpa. Funny, I know, but it really is so. I'm my own grandpa.
This song I wrote 3 years old, 3 years old now, this song is, and, I just sing this song a bit, riding on the city, Illinois Central, Monday morning, rain, there's 15 cars, restless rider. Three can. Oh, you must be kidding me. You know where that other thing is?
Porters and the sons of engineers, all right there, Daddy's magic
carpet made of steam. Mothers with the babes asleep go rocking to the gentle beat, and the rhythm of the rails is all they dream. Just singing good morning America, yeah. Say don't you, don't be, I'm your native son. And I'm the train they call the city of New Orleans. Gone 500 miles when the day is done. Mississippi darkness rolling to the sea. All the towns and people seem to fade into a bad dream, and the steam rail still ain't heard the news. The conductor sings that song again, if passengers will please refrain, this train's got the disappearing railroad blues. Good man, America, how are you? Sit on you. I'm your native son, and I'm the train that they call the city of New Orleans. Gone 500 miles when the day is done. Singing goodnight, America, how are you? And don't you know me, I'm your native son, your native son. I'm the train they call the city of New Orleans. Gone a long, long time when the day is done.
Before it says someone asked me if I was tired of singing that, the answer is no. I said that when I get tired of eating, I guess I get tired of singing the song. Luckiest thing I ever had, I mean. I mean, I could have been doing this in the bathroom, really. So, probably still will be at some time in the not too distant future. that was really crazy. Yeah, I had a bad dream that I had to lip sync the song on Bandstand. Everybody in the peanut gallery there with Dick Clark. Did you ever hear the little engine that could as a kid? Clarissa. And all these pictures of trains, you know. Yeah, that was a coordinated thing to do. Just fall into everything.
Great.
Still had a mind of its own. It was moving. Still, thing ain't working out. I've got to make a guitar strap here. Hold on a minute. This guitar doesn't have a button on the end like that one does. Cuts the nuts off of the guitar and raises its voice. Thank you. song. He wrote, he wrote a thing called Everybody's High Except For Me. He only had one verse in it that was of note. Anyhow, it was a... My girlfriend Lucy thinks that I'm so square. Her scorn is too much to bear. My best friend Melvin takes her everywhere. What a fascinating thing to delve in. Lucy in the sky with Melvin. Always liked that. And she had to be there. Oh, he wrote the original sexist rag with apologies to everybody. Just a weird song. I could learn to speak Vietnamese by myself, and I could even teach it to my good dog, Ralph, and I could learn to read you every book on the shelf, and I could tell your fortune like the Oracle of Delphi, and I could learn to tell you every flower by its color, and I could even swim as fast as Johnny Weiss's mother, but I never could learn to get along without you. Don't you run away from me, I sure dig sex. Get love from your mama or your papa. You can get steam from a Turkish or a sauna. And you can get hot from tortillas or lasagna. But you get all three when you make it with me. I must admit it gets me in my shoulder. Let's just win to think about the differences there are between the sexes. Pizzas and beer is me. When you get right down to it, though, it can't compete with good old double S. Double X is camper than Batman and bigger than Texas, and you're concave and I'm convex. As welcome to the world. Do I love you? Is the Pope Catholic? Do I need you? Is a rubber band elastic? Do I want you? Is the atom bomb drastic? Let's be heterosexually entwined with it like a Hong Kong suit. I dig you more than I dig root beer. Green giant peas need a big green pot, and I spend a lot of time eating your body. Here we go walking through fields of clover. Can't we lie down and talk things over? You never know what's coming off next. In a wonderful world. And just to show you that he has a serious side, he wrote this thing here. This is a gem. This is the only, just to show you that the same person can write two different kinds of things. This is one of the best songs of this kind ever written by anybody. It's the only love song I know that does not grunt. You know? And at the same time, it's the most sensual song I ever heard in my life. You know, it manages to do all those things. Only three verses. I don't know how he did it. The Dutchman is not the kind of man. Keeps his thumb jammed in the dam that holds his dreams in. That's a secret that only Margaret knows. When Amsterdam is golden in the summer, Margaret brings him breakfast and she believes in. Thinks the tulips bloom beneath the snow. Mad as he could be, but Margaret only sees that sometimes. Sometimes she sees her unborn children in his eyes. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise up above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man. Dear Margaret remembers that for me. The
Dutchman still wears wooden shoes and his cap and coat are patched with the love that Margaret sold there. Sometimes he thinks he's still in Rotterdam. Watches tugboats down canals and calls out to them when he thinks he knows the captain. Margaret comes to take him home again through the unforgiving streets that trip him. Though she holds his arm and sometimes he thinks he's alone and he calls her name. Let us go to the banks of the ocean where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man, and here Margaret remembers that for me. Winds his muffler tighter and they sit in the kitchen. Some tea with whiskey keeps away the dew. Then he sees her for a moment and calls her name. She makes the bed up singing some old love song. Margaret learned that song when it was very new. He hums a line or two and they sing together in the dark. The Dutchman falls asleep and Margaret blows the candles out. Let us go to the banks of the ocean where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers. Town to look for some work. Every place she applied, they said that she was qualified to be a secretary or a clerk. And the word got out on the day she was born, but she was 25 years getting the news. She had the "I don't know where I'm going, but I'm going nowhere in a hurry." Felt lucky last Tuesday, and he took himself down to the track, and he was armed with a high tip, and he had $100 bill, but that stud had to hitchhike back. The horse that he bet on was beaten all the way, and then it tossed off one of its shoes. That horse had the "I don't know where I'm going, but I'm going." Man
and inside. Don't know where I'm going and how long this journey will last. And inside, don't know where I'm going. The future is one big mirror of the past. I've been doing so long that it looks just like winning. And if you kick me again, I'm gonna come up grinning. All my time I've been standing still. It's the world that's spinning round so fast. And it was on a Sunday morning about 100 years ago. The message came with no warning, though everybody told him, and everybody told him so. And the last thing I heard old General Custer say, when he looked up and saw the Sioux, well, son, I got the eye, don't know where I'm going, but I'm going nowhere in a hurry, blues. And the last thing that Adolf Eichmann said, in that courtroom full of Jews, 'cause I got the head on over, I'm going. Them all going in a hurry, and the last thing that Marie Antoinette said, just before her head rolled down to her shoe, was, let them eat the I don't know where I'm going.